Hello friends, I am Mr. Sanjeev B. Naik, working in Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am going to solve the problem based on design and natural tolerances which are used in engineering practice. So at the end of session, learners will be able to solve the similar problems on design and natural tolerances, which are commonly used in engineering practice. So this is an example where the shaft is produced on particular manufacturing setup. The diameters of the shafts that produced on that setup are going to vary in their basic dimensions, and that's why they are normally assumed to be distributed with a mean value of 40.02 mm having a standard deviation of 0.02 mm. So it is assumed that the variation provided by manufacturing setup follows normal distribution curve having its mean value 40.02 mm and having standard deviation of 0.02 mm. Whereas the designer has specified the limit as the design tolerance for the shaft diameter as 40 plus 0.05 mm as upper dimension limit and 40 minus 0.03 mm as a lower dimension unit, where 40 is basic size. So the designer has provided basic size 40 mm on which he has specified the upper and lower dimension variation as a design tolerance. Now, as per the requirement of design tolerance, if this is been manufactured on particular manufacturing process which has got its own natural tolerance, then what will happen about rejection? That is, whatever quality is expected by the designer, that maintaining the dimension between this limit is possible for all the parts produced or not, because the design tolerance is different and natural tolerance is different. That we can analyze over here. So first we decide whether there is any rejection, if at all, and if it is rejection, how many shafts are likely to be rejected in terms of percentage. So percentage shafts likely to be rejected. So this is what expected answer. So for that, what we do, we first calculate absolute tolerances just by establishing what is known as lower limit for natural tolerance. We know that as the natural tolerance is distributed by a normal distribution curve, which is expressed as lower limit and upper limit with the value mean minus 3 sigma is the lower limit of that curve, and that is 39.96 mm, whereas the upper limit of natural tolerance will be mean plus 3 sigma. So total range or dispersion is between these two limits, lower limit and upper limit. So upper limit is mean plus 3 sigma, and that results to be 40.08 mm and 39.96 mm. So for natural tolerance, we establish two limits, upper and lower limit of dimensions in which all the shafts will vary which are been manufactured. Similarly, for design tolerances, directly we have specified the limit as x1. How? If it is lower limit, we get 40 minus 0.03 mm is the minimum dimension which has been allowed by the designer to maintain the quality, and that's why it is 39.97, whereas the upper limit is 40 plus 0.05, and that's why 40.050. So 40.050 mm will be the upper limit of design tolerance. So by knowing these two tolerance, we can further work out with the requirement. So just understand and just recall what is the significance of upper limit and lower limit of dimensions in manufacturing considerations, in product design, or in acceptance of the product as a quality. So just we have seen that we have established these two limits, natural tolerance and lower limit and upper limit, design tolerance, lower limit and upper limit. Now this tolerance, that is the difference between these two, is distributed as a mean curve. So this is a normal distribution curve between which we decide the lower and upper limit. So this is a curve which is referred for natural tolerance because it is a manufacturing process. Actually, product is manufactured according to this variation, which is distributed between minus 3 sigma to plus 3 sigma, and that sigma is converted into normal deviate z value because the standard curve is converted into real application of practical application in which we convert standard deviation standard into required standard deviation, that is value of z. Okay, so that is what a natural tolerance. So this natural tolerance is between minus 3 to plus 3. That is what a natural tolerance is been shown, which exists with its lower limit value 39.96 and upper limit value 40.08 mm. So which is shown over here. So this gives the natural tolerance dispersion. Okay. So whereas what is design tolerance? Design tolerance is 39.97 lower limit and 40.05 upper limit. So this difference between two values is actually design tolerance. So means what? Designer is expected variation between these two limits which are accepted for its functional requirement. If it is not lying in this region, then it is not accepted. So it is rejected. So this gives certain idea about considering lower limit, upper limit of design and natural tolerances, that there can be certain rejection over here because the manufacturing dimension is more than expected design dimension as a limit. And that's why the shaft which will have dimensions more than 40.05 till 40.08, these are not accepted. So it is rejected. So this way, this analysis will help us. So we have to establish this in terms of Z, so that area under the curve, which is provided by standard tables or standard charts, considering standard normal curve by central limit theorem, and that is what standard dimensional areas are known. So to make it that, what we calculate first, what is the standard deviation of this dimension with respect to mean, where Z is 0. So that we calculate at X1, and that value of Z1 is given as X1 minus mu upon sigma standard deviation, like this. 39.970 is lower limit and mu is 40.02, standard deviation is this, so minus 2.5. So Z value at this means what? This level is lying at 2.5 minus value of Z here, this value. This we can establish. Similarly, we can calculate Z according to this line as 40.0 upper limit, that gives Z2 plus 1.5. So this is a Z value plus 1.5. And that's why the area under the curve between standard deviations minus 2.5 to plus 1.5, which is value of Z, is within design tolerance, which is going to be accepted as a required quality of the shafts. And anything beyond this, like this, it is a rejection. So here any dimension lies after 40 point something towards this, it is not accepted. So this is a rejected number of shafts as a percentage. This is a rejected number of shafts as a percentage. So area under the curve directly reflects the percentage of either rejection or acceptance. And that's why if I want to know how much percentage of shaft is rejected, I want to calculate area, shaded area, this area plus this area. This is my need of problem to solve. And as design tolerance is less than natural tolerance, the first answer is that there is a rejection. So as design tolerance is less than natural tolerance, there is always rejection. So rejection is going to occur definitely, and that is equal to the area under this shaded curve. That we can calculate. So percentage of rejection of shafts produced will correspond to the shaded area under the curve as shown. So we calculate from standard the shaded area. So the first area we calculate between Z is equal to 0 to 2.5. So z is equal to 0 to 2.5 and then from 0 to 1.5. So total area is between minus 2.5 to 1.5. That is been obtained between 0 and this value and between 0 and this value from standard table. It is obtained as 0.4938 plus 0.4332. That is area between this area. That is what between the quality norms. So it is accepted. And that's why the area of rejection is obtained considering entire area under the curve, which is 1, that is 100, minus this value, which is accepted. So it gives 1 minus 0.927 and that results to be 0.073 area. So this area plus this area is aggregate to nearly 7.3%. So percentage of rejection of shaft is 7.3%. So this is the way we can first identify as the design tolerance is less than natural tolerance, there is a rejection, inherent rejection, and that rejection total is about 7.3%. So if 1000 shafts are produced on this manufacturing system, nearly 73 shafts will be rejected. So that way the decision making analysis can be made by using this statistical technique in considering design and natural tolerances. So this is my reference. Thank you.